Good Thursday morning. Last Sunday, I preached about when Jesus got good and mad. There are three specific records in Scripture of Jesus being angry and not sinning. Jesus never sinned when he got mad. I doubt very seriously that that can be said about anyone other than the Lord. Mark Twain said, "Anger is an acid that can do more harm to the vessel in which it is stored than to anything on which it is poured." Generally speaking, anger should be avoided as much as possible. In response to issues like abuse, injustice, mistreatment, healthy anger can motivate us to find solutions. The danger, as Twain observed, occurs when we hold on to our anger, letting it seethe. Unresolved anger always gives way to bitterness. Bitterness poisons our perspective by focusing on the sins of others while forgetting we've fallen short ourselves. Unresolved anger, it always gives way to bitterness. 2 Samuel chapter 3 chronicles a feud between the houses of Saul and David. Abner, a member of Saul's family, was working to transfer power to David. Joab was an influential member in David's family, but early on in the feud, Abner had killed one of Joab's brothers in self-defense. And understandably, Joab was angry, but he held on to that anger, allowing it to become bitterness. During the negotiation process, Joab arranged for a private meeting with Abner, and he killed him. His bitterness caused him to lose sight of God's promise, drove him to murder, and cursed his family for generations. We can avoid the dangers of unresolved anger by remembering God has forgiven our sins. Jesus paid for our sins by dying on the cross, so that through his death and resurrection, we may be forgiven and have a relationship with him. When we grasp the fact that our debt has been cleared, our appreciation should leave no room for bitterness towards anyone. Lord, far too many of us are still dealing with unresolved anger. Somehow we lose sight of your forgiveness of our sins as we are holding on to bitterness. Lord, set us free. Holy Spirit, fill us with your power that we may have the courage to seek resolution instead of revenge. Lord, even though we know that it's possible to be angry and not sin, for most of us our anger, it's not aimed at problems, it's aimed at people. And that anger never ends well. Fill our hearts with so much love that there's simply no room left for anger. In the holy name of Jesus we pray. Amen. God bless you. See you tomorrow.